Hi, welcome back. So in this lecture, we are going to log into our WordPress website backend. So WordPress dashboard, we are going to log in. So to log into your dashboard, you type your WordPress website URL and then give /wp-login.php. You will get this login page. Here you type your username, which you have created, type your password and then click on login. So when you click on login, you will be taken to the WordPress admin dashboard, from where we can control our website, WordPress website. So right now how our website is looking, that's what we are going to see. So it's about /business, right? So this is the dashboard of our WordPress website, and this is the website right now. It is looking like this. So this is the website title, subtitle, and here the sample post, and this is how our WordPress website is looking right now. So we'll look at the admin panel. See here we have the website name, and then there is a widget site link is there, which will take you to the website. Here some notification, message notification, and then here home and updates. If any updates are there, you will be notified here. And then we have the post, from where we can create a post, blog post, or any post we can create, add, and we can create a category, we can create tags. Then we have a media library where we can add the videos, images and all. We have the links tag where we can add a new link, a link categories. Then we have the pages where we can create a page and we can view all the pages. We have the comment where we can see all the comments people are commenting on our post or website or pages, that we can monitor here. We can click on the comment and we can see the what are the comments. See here, now right now there is a one comment, so it is showing. We can unapprove it, we can delete it, we can edit it, we can trash it. Okay, and then we have appearance tag. Then we have the plugins, from where we can download and install the plugin. Then we have the users, where you can create a new user to your website. Right now see Sunil, one user is there. That means we can create more users. We can manage profile from here, your profile link, and with add new we can add a new user. Then we have our tools settings. Okay, so all these options are there. Okay, so this is the profile. You can select the profile type, like a profile background image and all those things. You can username, password, name, everything you can give here. Here you can choose the what you want to display, Sunil or admin. Okay, here you can give the nickname, contact information, website for your user. You can create on the new, we'll see in detail all these things, but right now we are going through the overview. So here we have the tools, import, export. Okay, GoDaddy quick setup is also there. So then we have the settings for general, writing, reading. So we can specify the settings for writing, reading, discussion, media, permalinks, all those things. Then we have this clips setting that we discuss later. So all these things are we are going to discuss in the WordPress basic overview, basic section, where we'll be seeing how we can create a post, how we can manage the media, how we can manage the links, how we can create the pages, how we can manage the comments, how we can modify our appearance. So let's look at the appearance once. Okay, so let's click on the customize. So we can see what we can modify. We will try to modify the blog name and subtitle for now. So see here we can see. So here it will be, here the preview of our website will be displayed, and here from here we can modify the website. Okay, the see here now we have this. So here we can change the theme, here we can change the subtitles. So suppose I want to give the website name as Is Your Success. okay, and here subtitle, see here I'm changing here and it is getting changed, reflected here, and then I can give here subtitle tutorials, tips and online courses. Okay, so see here how beautifully it is coming along with our changes. Then here we can change the color, default color, yellow, pink, whatever you want. You can see here how it is getting change. So let it be default. Same way we can change the sidebar text color. Then we can put the header image if you want, and then we can put the header background image. We can add the widgets. So all these things we are going to see in the next section. We can choose the front page, the static front page, or you want to your latest blog post to be shown on your website. So click on save and publish, and let's refresh this and see what see here now website name has changed, the subtitle has changed. Okay, so this way we can change, and if you want you can change the theme. See here right now we are using 2015, we can use this 2013 and see how it will be looking. And right now I have clicked on the preview, so it will show if we activate it how it will look like. So see here, if you activate the 2013, it will, your website will be look like this. So let's activate it and refresh this and see how it is looking. See here now it is coming along with a different look. So see here we have a footer with some links, and then we have the blog post here, we have the about page by default here, and then we have this website name and subtitle with a nice background. So this way we can change the theme. So see you in the next lecture where we'll start with the WordPress basics.